I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Yahweh being the true, proper name of the Heavenly Father, who the world eagerly called God, the creators of the heaven and earth, and his Son, Yahweh Shai, who the world eagerly called Jesus Christ. Okay? Esso Christos. Alright? Jesus. Now, this is a dialogue or a question to vigilant Christian, a response to vigilant Christian, because out of nowhere, he wants to attack the faith of the Hebrew Israelites, which we are not black Hebrew Israelites, we are Hebrew Israelites. And the reason we call ourselves Hebrew Israelites is because we believe, we have faith in the prophecies that's written throughout the scriptures, in the Torah, the Tanakh, the Gospels and the Epistles and Revelation. Okay? We believe that we are the chosen people of God through biblical prophecies, because the things that's going on with our people lives, the condition that we live in, the condition that we of our oppressors, of our conquerors, it all links with biblical prophecy. And we're not black Hebrew Israelites because so-called Puerto Ricans are Israelites. So-called Native Americans are Israelites. So-called Seminole Indians are Israelites. So-called Aztecs, which are Mexicans, are Israelites. The Mayans, the Cubans, the Argentinians, the Brazilians, the indigenous people of North Central South America are also Israelites. So that's a cut right there on your ignorance, vigilant Christian. Okay? So I want to get into scriptures to show you. You greatly err not knowing the scriptures, all right? And what you're doing is biblical prophecy, which you don't like to go into, because you are not the chosen of the Most High. You are not the anointed of the Most High. You wasn't chosen to preach his word, okay? You greatly err not knowing the scriptures, because only his chosen people, his prophets, his seers, his watchmen was elected to bring out his word. Only Israelites was elected to bring out his word. And that's all throughout the scriptures. All right. Now, I want to go into the first one, showing you that it's prophecy that you're trying to denounce our faith. It's prophecy that you're trying to, that you're coming up against us all of a sudden. Because we pushed at the prophecies that's written throughout the Bible, which shows the end of America, the destruction and the great judgment of America, and the judgment of the wicked of the planet Earth. Because God, who you call God, which his true name in the Hebrew is Yahweh, through his son Yahweh Shai, is going to wipe away the wicked from this planet Earth. And the wicked of this planet Earth is you Edomites, which is the descendants, which is the progenitor of you white people. Okay? You are the wicked of the planet Earth. So, first things first, this is Hosea chapter 1, verse 10. It says, yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sands of the sea, which cannot be measured or number. And it shall come to pass, in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, it shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living God. So, that's cut number one, vigilant Christian. You're trying to denounce the faith of the Hebrew Israelites. You're trying to denounce the faith of the people that believe upon the Most High and his son. So I'm going to read it again. It says, yet the number of the children of Israel shall be as the sands of the sea, which cannot be measured or numbered. So we are the highest population of people on the planet of the earth. The children of Israel, which are you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, indigenous people of North, Central, and South America. You are the highest population on the planet Earth, despite what the so-called white man Esau tells you. You're not the minority. You're the majority. Okay? Because that's what the Bible says, and that's what we believe. It reads, and it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people, which is America, which is everywhere you Israelites dwell, which vigilant Christian says, It says, in the place where it was said unto them, ye are not my people. That's what you're saying, that we're not the Hebrew Israelites. But the funny thing is, you don't say who are the Hebrew Israelites. You don't say who is the chosen people of God. That's the funny thing. So it says, ye are not my chosen people. You are not my people. There it shall be said unto them, ye are the sons of the living God. And that's you so-called Negroes, West Indian and Haitian, and indigenous people of North, Central, and South America. You are claimed to be savages. That's why they call you Indians. Ye are called the scum of the earth and thugs and gangsters. You're not called the chosen people of God. This so-called white man, which is known as Esau in the Bible, he character assassinated you. He treaded your name in the Maya, which is a part of the curses of Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, which vigilant Christian will not cover. He will not cover the prophecies in the Bible. But in Deuteronomy, in the 28th chapter, it says that our people will be called a proverb and a byword. Everything that's not our real names. That's why we don't go out by our biblical identity. Read it on. It says, then shall the children of Judah and the children of Israel be gathered together. And that's what's happening today. This is prophecy being fulfilled before your eyes. The people of Judah, which Judah is the kingdom of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, and the kingdom of Israel is the other 10 tribes. It says they're going to be coming back together. That's why all 12 tribes are coming back together today before your eyes. That's why we waking up to who we are. Because the power of God, who the world ignorantly called God, and through his son, we are coming back together to who we are. We're waking up to who we are, and we're repenting because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Okay? So the next scripture, I want to go into the point, because if vigilant Christian has the truth, which his truth is plantation Christianity, is the Christianity that our slave masters, our conquerors was pushing on us, because it wasn't the truth of the Bible, okay? The God loves everybody. God, he so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. They pushed this love doctrine, but all they show is hate. All they show is bloodshed. Let's get that scripture, because that's biblical prophecy as well. See, vigilant Christian, what you fail to realize, biblical prophecy slashes and cuts everything that you say and believe in. Okay? This is Psalms chapter 55. Psalms chapter 55, verse 20. He put forth his hand against such as be at peace with him. He have broken his covenant. And that's what the so-called white man known as Esau in the Bible did. You broken every treaty and every covenant that you made with the indigenous people of North, Central, South America. You broken every treaty and every covenant you made with the so-called African-American, West Indian, and Haitian. It says, he have put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. When you came to the shores of America, when you couldn't survive on this land. The indigenous people showed you how to survive the winters. The indigenous people show you how to use the herbs. He showed you how to survive on this land because this was a wilderness to you. But what did you do? You stabbed them in his back. You gave them smallpox. You slaughtered their women and children. You raped, robbed, and murdered this land, man. You said you discovered a land that was already inhabited. Reading on, the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. Meaning the so-called white man, which is Esau, he always had an ulterior motive. Just like the American government today, and just like hip-hop and all the things that this America government pushes, which this world pushes, which is darkness, evil, and wickedness. Transgressing the laws of the Heavenly Father. Promoting anti-Messiah, anti-anointed, which is anti-Christ, as you call it. So it says, the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, but yet were they drawing swords. And that's what you do. That's your MO. You have always have an ulterior motive. The works of your hands is always death and destruction, bloodshed and robbery, man. Get one more scripture on this topic. This is the book of Proverbs. The book of Proverbs, chapter 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. When you look at the state of the planet Earth right now, and you see the state that the people are in, the people are in a deep slumber. The people are in a deep abyss of darkness, of wickedness and evil. Everything that the Most High said that was good, the world is adverse to. The Most High said man and woman is good, and they shall be fruitful and multiply, but this world pushes man on man. This world pushes woman on woman. This world pushes adultery. This world pushes sluts and whores. This world pushes everything that's contrary and adverse to the scriptures. So the scriptures say that when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. So the people are not in a state rejoicing. That's why there's chaos going out through the planet Earth. That's why there's wars and rumors of wars and uproars of the people. That's why there's civil unrest. That's why there's race riots. Because the wicked is in rulership. So it says, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. And what's righteousness? The commandments, the Lord's statutes, commandments, the words of the Heavenly Father and His Son. That's righteousness. Is the words of the Heavenly Father and His Son being dictated on the planet Earth? Hell no. So the people are not rejoicing. But it says, when the wicked bear fruit, the people mourn. And that's why you see the world in a state of mourning. People are strung out on drugs. People are strung out on alcohol. People are strung out on pharmaceutical drugs. People are strung out on the philosophies and the ways of this world that do as thou wilt, the Aleister Crowley philosophy, which is all darkness and contrary to the Heavenly Father and His Son. Now, I have a question for you, vigilant Christian. If your way of the Bible, believing in the faith and believing in the scriptures, was the truth, why isn't the kingdom of heaven set up yet? Why isn't the kingdom of heaven set up? You still coming with that Christianity, a plantation Christianity. God loves everybody. God don't hate. God is not evil. When the Bible completely teaches otherwise. The scriptures say that he created light and darkness. He says he created good and evil. The Heavenly Father is perfect balance. You can't have one without the other. How would you know what pain, how would you know what joy is if you didn't have pain? How would you know what happiness is if you didn't have sadness? How would you know what joy is if you didn't know anger? The Most High created all emotions, all feelings. You gonna say that man is better than the Heavenly Father, the creator of all things? You saying that man can have feelings that the Most High doesn't know about? Are you out of your goddamn mind? Real quick, this is 1 Samuel, because I want this to be quick, because I know y'all people got short attention spans. This is 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 6. This was a song that Hannah had sang, the wife of Samuel. And it says, 1 Samuel 2 and 6, the Lord killeth and maketh alive. So the Most High, the creator of heavens and earth, he's the one that kills. He's the one that brings death. He killeth and maketh alive. He's the one that brings life on the earth. So you say that the Heavenly Father doesn't have the power to take life and give life? He killeth and maketh alive. He bringeth down to the grave and bringeth up. The Lord maketh poor and the Lord maketh rich. He bringeth low and lifteth up. Come on, man. One more precept to that. Because the Bible deals with precept. The scriptures say, line upon line, precept upon precept. To get understanding on one scripture, you got to go to another chapter, another book, and another verse. So this is Songs chapter 68. Songs chapter 68, verse 20. It says, he that is our God is the God of salvation. and unto God the Lord bringeth the issues of death. So the reason why death goes on in the planet Earth, because the Most High clocked your time sheeted, man. The Most High is the one that brings death on Earth. And when the masses of these people die, that's going to be sanctioned by the Heavenly Father. When the Most High brings judgment on the planet Earth, that's going to be sanctioned by the Heavenly Father. Now, like, going back to the question, you saying your Christianity, your belief, your faith, which the Roman Catholic Church pushes, which is all the, which all theologian thoughts pushes, God loves the world, everybody can be saved, everybody can believe. Why isn't the kingdom of heaven here on earth yet? Why didn't the Heavenly Father send his son to redeem his elect? If your way of thought and belief, which has the masses of believers on the planet Earth, the biggest religion on Earth today is Roman Catholicism and Christianity, that has the masses of the people of the world believing in that, why isn't the kingdom of heaven here yet? Because the Heavenly Father and his son doesn't deal with the majority. The Heavenly Father and his son don't deal with the masses. The scriptures say that a remnant of his people, which are the Israelites, which are you so-called African Americans, West Indians, Haitians, and indigenous people of North, South, Central America. He said a remnant of his people is going to come back to who they are and repent and acknowledge the creator of heaven and earth and believe upon his word and serve him. This is Luke, Matthews, chapter 7, verse 13. It says, enter ye in a straight gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many be which go in thereat. So I'm going to read it again and break it down. It says, enter ye in a straight gate. Straight, meaning a position of difficulty. Not straight, meaning a straight line, but straight as a position of difficulty. Because when you come into the faith and believing in the scriptures, the words of the Heavenly Father and his son, is going to be difficult. Okay? You're going to go through persecution of the people. You're going to suffer because you're not a part of this world. Like our Lord and Savior has said, we are not of this world. So the world is not going to accept us or love us, which vigilant Christian doesn't do. But he's a non-believer anyway. He's an Edomite. All right? He's an Edomite. And the scriptures say that none of the wicked shall understand. They ain't going to understand the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. They ain't going to understand what was revealed unto his men, his servants, the prophets, which visually Christian is not a prophet. So it says, enter ye at the straight gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. So the masses of you believers of Roman Catholicism and Christianity and in different schools of thought of theologians, you are the wide and broad gate that's leading to destruction. So it says, and many there be go in thereat, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leads unto life, and few there be that find it. So only few is going to find the right way to the Messiah and to the Heavenly Father. Only few is going to find the right way back to who they really are. All right? Because we all have biblical identities, despite what visually Christian says. And you so-called African Americans, West Indians, and Haitians, and indigenous people of North, South, Central America, Mexicans, Hispanics, Cubans, Brazilians, Argentinians, all right, Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, you are the Israelites, according to the Bible and biblical prophecy. And the straight and narrow way is what's going to lead on to life, man. And I could keep going on and on, man, because there's tons of things you lack and you err not knowing and understanding of the scriptures. All right? But I wanted to keep this brief and short for the believers and the followers and the ones that's going to see the light and hear the voice of the shepherd and come back to him. Because despite final scripture, man, like I said, I could keep going, man. I could keep going. All right? Because this is the words of the Messiah. This is St. John, chapter 10. Give me 1 second. This is St. John chapter 10, verse 14. I am the good shepherd, and know my sheep, and am known of mine. And the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. And other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, them also must I bring. The other sheep he bring up, who the world ignorantly called Jesus Christ is talking about, the other 10 tribes, the exiled Jews and the Israelites that were scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. Because where Jesus was, who you call Jesus, he was in Jerusalem. He was in the land of Israel. And the tribes that was in the land of Israel at that time was Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, the house of Judah. The house of Israel as a whole was in that land at the time. So the other sheep that our Lord and Savior was talking about, the other Israelites that were scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, and the exiled Jews. So it says, and other sheep I have which is not of this fold, the fold of the house of Judah, them also I must are not of this fold. So, forgive me. I'm going to read it again. And other sheep I have which are not of this fold, them also I must bring. And they shall hear my voice, and they shall be one fold and one shepherd. Therefore doeth my Father love me, because I laid down my life that I might take it not again. All right? So the sheep hears the voice of the Messiah. The true believers, the Israelites, the elect, they're going to come back no matter what you devils say. You deceivers, you adverse to the scriptures say. You Satanists. The true believers of the Bible is always going to come back. The elect is going to come back. But with that, I hope you was edified. And this is a response of Vigilant Christian. I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah for putting the spirit upon me for doing this lesson. Until next time, I say Shalom.